first picture, if you're on the phone, I'll try and describe these pictures. The first picture is a picture of normal chromosomes. And just as a reminder, we should have 23 chromosomes from mom and 23 from dad for a total of 46. There needs to be these lovely little pairs. So what we see here, and this is just an illustration of what the nucleus would look like with all these little chromosomes, there's a pair of ones, a pair of twos, all the way down until you get down here to the sex chromosomes. And, of course, Down syndrome is an excess of this, chromosome 21. The point being that for a cell to function properly, it's best to have the complete library, the complete Encyclopedia Britannica, if you will. Now, what happens with cancer, and we know this from looking at cancer cells in the same way, is that we get a mixture. We don't get those pairs. We get three of number seven, three of number eight, maybe, you know, none of a certain, or number, or four of these. And we also see these weird crossovers in the colors. And this just tells us that the number of ways that chromosomes can become, distributed improperly is infinite. Here's an illustration of what happens every time a cell divides. 23 and 23 line up, and these little microtubules form what's called spindles, and they pull them apart. And this is happening all the time, billions of times every day in your body, and there can be problems. If you think of it as trapeze artists lined up across the middle, you know, if they're not properly segregated, then you can get problems, and you can get this kind of thing where they're not distributing properly. Now, luckily, the cell is completely equipped to deal with this. On this slide, we have just an illustration. Before the cell divides, it asks itself, there are mechanisms to ask whether it's damaged, whether there's enough resources to even divide into. And if so, then it'll go ahead and copy its DNA. In the second phase, it doesn't copy the DNA, it copies the RNA and all the little protein signatures that tell you what specific function that cell has. And this is a very important checkpoint. M is mitosis. That's when the cell divides. That needs to make sure that everything's even. Now, if they're not even, as shown in this diagram, you have the spindles in a cartoon. They're pulling apart, but if there's not good tension on both sides, then you get a non-disjunction and you start getting back to that really bad situation. This has to do with telomeres. Well, telomeres, as we all remember, are these ends of the chromosomes, and they shorten every time the cell divides, which is fine, because if they didn't shorten, then every cell could be a potential cancer cell. But what we think now is that normal cells can't become cancer cells. See, they divide 60 times, and they just peter out, whereas stem cells are immortal by nature. And if they get messed up, then you have a cancer. So there's a school of thought now that all cancer is, in fact, a disease of stem cells, because run-of-the-mill cells can't cause that. I'll just close with this last slide here before we watch a video. This is just illustrating that, you know, this looks like a very busy slide, and indeed it is, but it's very critical. Everything on this page is very critical. And what we're seeing here, again, is the cell cycle right before cell division. All these processes are in place to repair DNA breaks, to detect critically short telomeres, and these are all critical. Any of these, if they're defective, can cause cancer, because in reality, the genome or the DNA is always being damaged, but in reality, it's always being fixed also. So when you have a situation where maybe this one is out, thank D, you get premature aging and premature cancer. Same with P53, deletions or mutations in this, cancer. So it's not so much the DNA repair or even the shortening of the telomeres that causes the problem. It's the failure of the many, many mechanisms of repair that causes cancer. This is an important picture showing that DNA gets broken by ultraviolet, stress, radiation, etc. And here's an interesting slide, which I hope you can see, showing one of the many, many repair mechanisms at work. And here you can see that the centromere, which is the center kind of the bow tie, and the telomere, which is indicated by blue circles here, these are really the control mechanisms of the every single chromosome. That's how you get a hold of it. And so here it's just being illustrated, a break is being repaired by this thing called SUMO. Anyway, the important part of this is that there are many ways to repair DNA, and they're always in process. And in fact, we'll learn later that the chemotherapy that we use depends upon the normal cell replication and cell repair mechanisms to work. I'd like to turn now to a video featuring Dr. Shima and one of his patients.
First of all, it's what was very attractive for me was the fact that it is derived from Chinese herb and organically grown, and we use huanchi or astragalus all the time. Yeah, I was very comfortable with it from the very beginning. Yeah, I know that it was not toxic. People have eaten that for 2,000 years or more, yeah. And then extracts from that cannot be toxic. So I felt very comfortable from the very beginning. Yeah, if it's some kind of a chemical compound that was derived by combining other chemicals, I'd be a little worried.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this is because it's more like a regular Western chemical compound than. 10 years down the line, you know, people say, "Well, you know, we didn't know that there's this side effect." You know, because it's come from the herbs which have been time tested at least for 2,000 years, I felt that there will not be a problem. The major benefit I have seen is among cancer patients. I see a lot of cancer patients after they have gone through their Western regimen of treatment, and they are exhausted, or they are fatigued, or they also feel wasted. And I don't treat cancer.
Sure. Yeah. I'm from here, Marin County, California. I live in Novato, and I've had a health condition, and tried a lot of conventional medicine, and still, you know, felt very tired and not really at an optimal level of health. And
did you respond to the conventional medicine?
No. Hmm. No, I didn't. No. I didn't.
Alertness?
Yes, more of an alertness. I feel calm, but I have energy. I feel like I can do anything I want, drive to the city, which is a half an hour away, meet a friend, whereas before I pretty much had to shut down my social life. Yes, I would, because there's nothing worse than being ill or feeling sick from side effects of some medications.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what the conventional medicine had, a lot of side effects. So this counteracted the side effects, and it, you know, there's when you can have your health back and participate in life, I think that's really worth the cost. I'm very excited about TA-65 because it repairs the damage from the chemo, radiation and chemotherapy, as we all know, damages the cells and the body in general. And there's a long recovery process of about a year people have to go through. So with the TA-65, it's doing that. It's repairing all that damage. And so that is very significant. Another thing I noticed on the TA-65 is my hair is growing, and it's grown about, I'm guessing about 2.5 inches out, and so I have a whole head of hair. It's probably more of a boy's style than a woman's style, but it's nice to see that usually on chemo, hair doesn't grow. Skin is very clear. I think it's maybe more youthful, maybe glows more, I would say, because this feels like to me like it's an energy going through me.
And I don't treat cancer, but I help them recover. Yeah, much faster than people who don't do anything. You know, they may be spending say 3 months to 6 months being tired, dragging around, like classical qi deficiency. Yeah, so I give them TA-65 right off the back, 100 milligrams a day, and then with no break in between. And then I notice immediately immediate improvement in the energy.
Dr. Park again. I wanted to go ahead and get some time with Dr. Shima, so I'm going to unmute his line, and hopefully he can hear us.
Yes, I can hear you.
Dr. Shima, can you hear us?
Yes.
Great. Welcome.
Thank you. How are you?
I'm great, thank you. Sorry for the audio difficulty, but...
Oh, no problem. We always have problems with audio or visual.
So we'll get that ironed out. Dr. Shima, as you heard, is treating a lot of people who are taking cancer therapy, and I think it might surprise people to know that he's actually had over 110 patients with active cancer. I'd like to ask you, you know, obviously they can't all be doing great, but can you give us an idea of do you have a lot of breast, ovary, lung, colon, what would you say the patients come to you with?
I have a lot of breast cancer patients, colon cancer. I have treated lung cancer patient recovering, and she battled with lung cancer for 6 years, but then passed on. And you know, liver—not primary, but colon cancer metastasis. I have one cholangioma patient actually doing very well. He's 55. He's a recovering alcoholic, and he basically his doctor, cancer doctor, said, you know, we did every chemotherapy we can do, and he just kind of go home and then just, you know, enjoy the rest of your time. So he came over and I said, I don't treat cancer, but I have Chinese herbs. And this is a very important thing that, number one is you need to give, or at least in my practice, we were trained to give one guiding herbal formula. That means that it would guide the TA-65 to a particular site, so that you give one formula to guide the TA-65 to work on particular part of the body.
Now, I've put Layla in, or Lila, and also Jackie, who
yes.
I know are patients of yours.
Right.
And I just wanted to open it up to them. Are you guys on?
Yes.
Yes.
This is Lila.
Oh, okay,
and Jackie.
Perfect.
Yeah.
So let me ask you, let me ask Lila first. I'm sure a lot of people told you that TA, you know, because telomerase is active in cancer, would just make things worse and was a terrible idea. How did you deal with that fear when you decided to start TA-65?
That was for Lila.
Well, the scientists.
Yeah, Lila or Jackie. Yeah.
The scientists say it's not true. So that's what I'm following what they're saying.
Yeah, I did a lot of research on it before I decided to start taking it. And from the studies that were done, like at Sloan Kettering and I believe UCLA, what it showed was at the very least that this would do would be to minimize the side effects of the chemotherapy. That was what made me decide to start taking it, that I wouldn't have a hard time doing the chemo. But what I found out was that I've been on a very low dose since I talked to Dr. Shima, and my tumors have not been growing. They've been steadily decreasing, and this was over the last year and a half now. Mm-hmm. So I started out with a 4-centimeter tumor, and it's now down to less than one.
Well, you know, it's interesting because, you know, obviously we're not saying that TA-65 is the cure for cancer. We can't say that, nor would we want to for everybody listening. But I think that what really comes out in listening to the interviews that Lila did was she felt that it gave her the strength to even get through the chemo. And she describes a kind of a healing energy.
Right.
Yeah, well, you know, it's funny because I was looking at Lila's history. We talked a bit last night in preparation, and she had really had a difficult cancer, one which really she shouldn't have even survived. And I was kind of startled to know that after going through chemo and radiation and chemo, she kind of hit that point that Dr. Shima said, where the oncologists and the traditional docs say, you know, it's time to just make your peace. But somehow you got on the TA and you managed to get your strength back, and somehow, surprisingly, you seem to be without evidence of disease. Tell me, how did you keep your spirits up during that time when you're just getting bad news and bad news?
I started to feel so good. I was so energized by it and clarity of thinking. And I actually, to tell you the truth, felt better than I did before the first diagnosis of cancer.
Hmm.
So I was just feeling really well. I have a very spiritual, very strong connection with God. I feel that I'm going to be okay. I've had this feeling throughout the whole time. I could go into another 2 hours about that, but I'm not going to. That's a personal thing.
Mm-hmm.
And I just felt I was going to be okay through it. So it's really hard for me to put that into words, but it was just my connection with God. I felt I was going to be okay.
Wow.
So.
Can I tell them what kind of cancer that you had?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so you had an ovarian cancer, which is typically a disease of women in their 60s. And, of course, it's the one that Gilda Radner had and the one that's associated with BRCA1. But most people think, you know, the BRCA genes, because they confer a 60% chance of breast and ovary cancer, that they're bad, when the exact opposite is true. The loss of those genes is what causes the loss of DNA repair and permits the cancers. But, you know, ironically, you know, the fact that you didn't have pregnancy as a teenager, really young, that may have contributed. And just for those who don't know, ovary cancer is preventable by 80% if you take birth control pills your whole life. Again, with the theory that if you don't use the ovaries, then you don't have those cell divisions. You don't have that telomere shortening and other chances to.
Well, that's not
get.
True, because I took
birth control pills.
Birth control pills, yeah, majority of my life. So it didn't seem to.
That's interesting.
That had
yeah.
validity whatsoever.
Right. Well, not for you, but, you know, for that's what we generally do when we have patients who are BRCA fragile. We do tend to put them on. But, yeah, there are other factors definitely contributing. And, Jackie, what kind of cancer did you have?
I have a small cell lung cancer.
Wow. So two very non-responsive cancers.
Right.
So you went from 4 centimeters to 1 centimeter?
Right.
Great. And did you do surgery and radiation and chemo?
No surgery. I did chemo to start with, and just because it had gotten down to the 1 centimeter, they decided to do radiation on it to see if they could stop it from coming back or growing again. Hmm. And so far I've been lucky. You know, I was told average is about 10 months, and like I said, it's been a year and a half, and I'm doing really well.
Wow. That's great. Now, Dr. Shima.
Yes.
Are you still there, sir?
Yes.
I mean, clearly you can't, you know, this is a horrible disease with poor prognosis for a lot of people, and they come to you quite late in their
right.
progress, hoping for a miracle. I mean, surely not everybody is doing well, and we talked
mm-hmm.
about the couple that you've lost.
Yeah.
But out of the 110, I know that there were a few who came very late with brain cancer, and the brain is
right.
a very privileged space, so I can understand that.
Right.
But are the majority of your other patients showing no evidence of disease, even throughout and after their chemo and radiation?
They are actually doing very well. I think I have to figure out the other things to give besides TA-65 to guide the herbs to the brain. As you know, brain has blood barriers, and it's very difficult to get a lot of things into the brain. And lots of times also brain tumor patients come to see me too late.
Yes.
Yeah, like one lady came and died a month later because it's just there's no way to make it turn around.
Right.
Yeah, but other cancers, you know, including this cholangiocarcinoma, which has less survival rate than pancreatic cancer, he's doing actually very well. He gained all his weight back after 220 pounds, and he's eating enormous meals, and he has no pain, and then the tumors are getting externalized. It's a very special word in Chinese that all these tumors are not really growing inside, but it comes out as lumps on the body.
Hmm.
So we can see them, and then we don't really don't do anything because I know that it's not going to kill the patient. It just looks it doesn't look good, but when I had the cholangiocarcinoma cancer patient last November. I said, oh my gosh, you know, I think the right guiding herbs to the gallbladder, and then he's taking a large amount of the herb at almost like a 24 capsules a day. He's a big guy, so 22 capsules, whatever, 10 pounds, one capsule
wow.
per 10 pounds of weight,
yeah.
and then 100 milligrams of TA-65. And he's actually doing very well. He has no more pain at all with eating. And he eats, sometimes he eats 1 pound of hamburger a day, organic hamburger a day. And he was a construction worker, and he's telling me that he's going to go back to work in construction. So he said, no, he's not going to do that.
That's amazing. Well,
yeah.
You know, the funny thing about it is, and each person has, of course, their own journey. And I, of course, I haven't treated that many cancer patients. I do have some cancer patients in the practice. And, of
uh-huh.
course, we have to reiterate that TA-65 is not FDA approved. It's not a cancer treatment.
No.
But do you think that the amazing anecdotal results people see are primarily because of the immune health, the immune system? Are the people themselves able to fight the cancer better, or is it the chemo and the radiation that's doing it?
Well, I think if you understand that the astragalus in Chinese medicine is what we call the qi tonic, it strengthens the life force. And basically you are condensing it by 5,000 times. You know, by the time you become TA-65, you're taking 5,000 times stronger astragalus than the decoction boiled in the pot.
Right.
So you can imagine how strong a stimulation is giving to a life force. Hmm. You know, so that life force can do a lot of things. It could also stimulate the immune system, and also it moves the fluid, what we call the yin in Chinese medicine. The fluid moves around. That also helps the blood to move around, and also detoxifies the lymph system, and all these things done by stronger life force. So, you know, if you're taking 100 milligrams of a TS65, you're talking about taking probably about 500 pounds of Huan Qi a year.
Yeah, that's amazing.
I don't know, it's probably three times more than my whole body weight.
500 pounds of what?
If you take
astragalus root, yeah.
Yeah, if you're taking the dosage you're taking, Lila, you're taking almost 500 pounds of astragalus a year.
Oh, wow.
Oh, that's you know, probably five times heavier than you are.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that kind of speaks to the point. People always ask, well, why is it so expensive? Well, it requires a lot of root to extract, and as one of my patients who's a chemical engineer says, it can't be synthesized. So it needs to be grown and extracted.
Right.
You know, it's really fascinating. I think we're going to definitely have to have Dr. Shima on again. I just wanted to thank everyone, because we have to end the call soon. I just wanted to ask Lila and Jackie, just as a closing note, I mean, I know, Lila, you experienced a lot of improved energy, and that showed up as a lot of great symptoms. I mean,
well, I went from totally being debilitated, not being able to drive, you know, I told you all that.
Right.
And not having a wheelchair in the hospital, going down hallways to my appointments, and having my sister nurse me as being my reality for about 2 months, and then going from this total transformation, physical and mental transformation, you know, into having energy, clarity of thinking, well-being, the nails getting stronger, the hair growing.
That's amazing. So what would you just... In closing, I'm sorry to interrupt, but in closing, if somebody's listening or they have a loved one or a family member who's doing what you did, and you did it for several years of fighting the chemo and the radiation and the cancer, what would you say to a person like that who maybe would consider TA-65? What kind of personal advice would you give them?
Well, I would say use it in conjunction with healing. Have a top-notch healer, best in their field. You know, top-notch healer, do the acupuncture, go twice a week, take the herbs, do this for 3-4 years. I did it for 2.5-3 years. I'm not clear on exactly when I stopped. But so I feel healing is a huge part of it. Then also take the TA-65 and take 100 milligrams. I would take the top dose.
Mm-hmm.
And, cancer is a whole surrounding thing. Eat organic foods, surround yourself with positive, loving people.
Yes.
Don't stress.
Yes.
Don't work. Do not work if you can. And just have a life of peace, you know.
Yeah, exactly. That's very great advice. And thank you. And Jackie, what would you say to people who are maybe thinking, is this for me? Is it something I should risk? Or what advice would you give to people who are considering TA-65?
Well, I agree with Lila totally. I think it's nothing but a benefit. It creates mood stabilization. You get that peaceful, I can deal with this feeling and not feel overwhelmed or stressed. I think it has helped a lot as far as dealing with the side effects of the chemotherapy. You don't get the nausea. You don't get that real lethargic feeling where it just wipes you out. You feel a little tired, but you don't feel like you need to sleep 20 hours a day.
Right.
It's a real benefit.
Right. And Dr. Shima, same question to you. You've treated, I have not even approached the number of cancer patients that you have.
Mm-hmm.
After seeing all these people and the journey and the struggle that they go through, what advice would you say to a patient that was also embarking on the cancer struggle?
Well, I think the most important thing is really do not lose any hope, and then have connection with God. I think you need a spiritual practice of some kind, and at the same time, find a good healer who really can guide you along with the TA-65. Like if you were in Chinese medicine, make sure that the person is trained and practiced for a long time to treat cancer patients, because this is a whole different can of worms from treating back pains or any other things, the cold or flu. You're talking about the whole different ball of wax. And then if the person is, you're the first patient, cancer patient, they want to take care of you. Then I wouldn't go to the person.
Sure.
I've been practicing for 40 years, working with MDs, always along with myself, and then always work with Western and Chinese medicine together. So that's very important.
I think it's true, and that's a great point. They don't call it alternative so much. I think the term now is complementary and
right.
alternative. So we're
right.
really looking not to choose Western or Eastern, but really to take the best of all fields.
Right, exactly. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's great. I wanted to close by thanking everyone, and just there's a slide up. I want to also review this. It's kind of a diagram I put together about cancer. And it kind of just shows if the horizon line is like clinically evident cancer, at the top we have these destructive therapies, which are very destructive and nonspecific. Chemotherapy, of course, is a poison which attacks all dividing cells. So you lose hair, you get, gastrointestinal problems, your immune system plummets. So, of course, you're killing all the good with the bad. Radiation, like the kind that Jackie would have had, is more localized, but again, it works by attacking rapidly producing cells. Surgery is the best once you have a clinical cancer because it's precise and it can cut it out, but of course, cancer spreads by lymph nodes. But I think the part of the equation that's ignored is the pyramid underneath, or the iceberg beneath the water. And at the very last bulwark is sort of the natural killers, which, as Lila said, your body, once the immune system recovers, is really trying to kill cancer. And you may have had cancer many times, which your immune system is curing. Beneath that, there's P53, which is the enzyme, among many other of those enzymes we showed, which can detect and is detecting constantly and trying to repair, put to sleep, or kill damaged cancer cells. But at the very base, I think, is the telomere protection, which, even if people don't take TA-65, the things that they do to stay healthy activate telomeres. And it's preventing the telomeres from getting short, because when they get short, they're recognized as DNA damage, and then they're spliced to places where they should not be spliced. And, of course, that showing in the literature is thousands and thousands of papers showing that the more erosion of the telomeres, the higher risk of cancer, and that goes for every cancer. So I think part of what we're trying to say here is that don't get to the top part of the pyramid if you can help it. Stay healthy with a good spiritual lifestyle, healthy eating, exercise, and do what you can to protect your telomeres, because we're believing that that's a big part of what causes cancer. Well, that's really what I wanted to say about the science part. Were there any final comments that you guys had, Jackie, Lila, Dr. Shima?
I'm just very pleased with the way that it's helped me. I think it's been beneficial in my recovery. I'm not there yet 100%, but I'm definitely a lot closer than I was a year and a half ago.
Great.
Yeah, that's so great. Well, thank you so much for sharing. And Lila, do you have anything you want to close with?
No, I'm just happy this is that I got TA-65. The first time I had an episode or diagnosed, I went through everything with no acupuncture, no TA-65, and it just felt literally like a bus ran over me, and I felt just totally wasted. But, so this is wonderful to have, and I just feel so much better.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for sharing. I really appreciate it. And Dr. Shima, we'll just close with you. Dr. Shima, of course, 40 years in Oriental medicine and has written several books and practices out of the Bay Area in Marin County, really has tools that, as regular allopathic doctors, we just don't have, and a great wisdom and experience. So, Dr. Shima, can you tell people how to get in touch with you?
Sure. The best way to do it is just to call me at my office, and the office number is 415, that's area code 415-924-2910. 924-2910. And just talk to my receptionist, and I would schedule an initial telephone consultation. And if you have any other pertinent medical literature, my fax number is the same area code 415-924-5072.
Perfect.
Thank you.
Okay. All right. Well, thanks, everyone, for joining in. This is Dr. Ed Park from Recharge Biomedical, finishing up a call with Dr. Shima and two of his patients. And I thank everyone for joining. And if you feel this was worthwhile, please tune in next week. We'll have another topic, and I'm sure we'll have Dr. Shima back.
Okay.
If you feel it's worthwhile, yeah, we'll go ahead and post this link, and you can forward it to other people as well.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dr.
Bye, everybody.
Thank you.
Okay.
Bye.
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 Thank you. Bye.